हे क्लास, हाय, हेलो, नमस्ते, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वणक्कम एंड खम्मा घणी टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वेलकम टू टुडेस क्लास एंड एज यू ऑल नो दिस इज योर आईसीएसई ग्रेड 10th एंड वी आर डूइंग आवर सेकंड सेशन फॉर योर अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। सो इन द फर्स्ट क्लास वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द जनरल टर्म ओके ऑफ एन एपी एंड वी हैव सॉल्वड सम क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू इट। इन टुडेस क्लास वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द सम ऑफ एन अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन एंड द क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू इट। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द क्लास। माय नेम इज गोपाल पालीवान एंड वेलकम टू टुडेस क्लास। एंड प्लीज डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक दिस वीडियो एंड शेयर द वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल। गॉट इट? सो दिस वॉज योर होमवर्क क्वेश्चन दैट हाउ मेनी थ्री डिजिट नंबर्स आर डिविजिबल बाय 87। ओके, तो यू नो दैट 87 इज अ टू डिजिट नंबर। वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द थ्री डिजिट्स नंबर दैट इज फ्रॉम 100 टू 999, राइट? इन दिस रेंज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस रेंज एंड वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी नंबर्स, थ्री डिजिट नंबर्स आर डिविजिबल बाय 87। तो देखो भाई, फर्स्ट नंबर तो यू कैन सी 87 विल नॉट कम इन दिस पार्ट बिकॉज 87 इज नॉट अ टू डिजिट नंबर। तो 87 इंटू 2 इफ आई विल डू, 2 सेवंस आर 14, पावर 1, 174 विल बी इन दिस पार्ट, तो 174 विल बी देयर। द नेक्स्ट नंबर विल बी 87 इंटू 3, तो 7 3 इज 21, पावर 2, 261। तो यू कैन क्लियरली सी एन एपी इज बीइंग फॉर्मड, राइट? देयर इज एन एपी which is being formed here. And the last number you can calculate which multiple of 87 is less than 999, that will be your last digit or the last term in this AP. So you can see 174, 961 and 957 will be the last term of this AP. ठीक है? The 957 will be your last term of this AP and it will be okay, it will be 87 into 11, sir. Okay, so you can say 7 plus 8 is 15, power 1, 8 plus 1, 9. Right, so this is how it will work. So 957, that will be the last term, because if you do 87 into 12, that will be a 4-digit number. So this is an AP. I know here the first term is 174, the common difference is 87. Okay, and I know that the last term, let's say nth term, is 957, so I need to find out the value of n. So 957 is 174 plus n minus 1 into 87. Shift 174 over there, so 783 is n minus 1 into 87 divided by 87, so it will be 9. Okay, 9 is equal to n minus 1, shift minus 1 over there, n is equal to 10. So there are total 10 numbers which will be divisible by 87 and which are 3 digit numbers as well. So correct answer is, how many numbers are present there? There are total 10 numbers present. Got it? Now let's come to today's part. So today's session we are talking about the sum of an AP. Okay, so it means ki suppose if I give you an AP that is suppose 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and suppose up to 20 I have given. So if I ask you ki bhai, what will be the value of 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 and up to 20. So what will be this value? So this is called the sum of an AP, SN. This is called what? Sum of an AP, SN. So the value of sum of an AP will be, the formula is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Ye formula hai. Or dekho, 2a plus n minus 1 into d I can write as n by 2 into 2a I can write as a plus a. 2a I can write as a plus a. Right, 2a I have written as a plus a, and then in addition with them we have plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, so if you look at this part, this is the last term of this AP. If I am adding up to n terms, so it will be the last term. So the another formula is SN is equal to n by 2. SN means sum of n terms is n by 2 into a plus the last term of n that AP, that is L. Got it? So these are the two formulas for the sum of an AP which you should remember, and these will be useful, hai na? Ye dono useful rahenge bahut zyada. If the last term is given, suppose if a AP is given to me like this, so I already know last term is 20, first term is 2. It is better to use this form, SN is equal to n by 2 into a plus n. So I will say that, sir, SN is equal to n by 2. अब देखो यहाँ पे I don't know the value of n. तो first I will find out the value of n into what I will say 2 plus 20 n by 2 into a plus n. Got it? So I have to find out the value of n and this will work. If I only know the value of a, n and d, I don't know what is the last term. So you can use this formula as well. So it's all one and the same thing. Got it? Nothing new. Just telling you the formulas. But the most important questions from this topic are of this form. When they will give you three or more terms in an AP and they will give you the sum, but or the sum will not be given, something else will be given, but the most important thing is they will not give you the value of A or D. So in that case we need to assume that AP, in that case we need to assume that AP in the forms of A and D. So how do you assume that AP? That is the most important thing. Dekho, first thing is you can always assume it as a plus d, a plus 2d, right? That is always the form, but it will be bit, I would say the question will become bit lengthy if we use this form every time, because nothing is being cancelled here. If three terms are given and if I add them, so it will become 3a plus 3d, right? So I still have a and d unknown. So better, what we'll do, we will change the form of this AP. So when the number of terms are odd, when the number of terms are odd, remember what you will do. First thing beta, yaad rakhna, the middle term we will keep as A. Okay, now A does not represent here the first term. It is just a variable. Our first term will be something else. So middle term, whatever is the middle term, we will keep it as A. Okay, before the middle term, whatever term is coming, that I will keep it as a minus d, and after that a plus d. If there is one more, so keep it as a minus 2d, and here a plus 2d, like that, right? So if n is equal to 3, this will be your AP. If n is equal to 5, this will be your AP. If n is equal to 7, so a minus 3d, a plus 3d, like that. So middle term will keep it as a, then a minus d, a plus d, a minus 2d, a plus 2d, a minus 3d, a plus 3d. So in that case, what is happening? If I add all of them, so minus d and plus d will get cancelled and we will get 3a equal to something. So value of a we will get as a number. So that is the use of form of using these forms of an AP. So once we have got one equation the value of a, then putting it in some other equation, I'll get the value of D as well, because then I have to be solving linear equations in one variable. Okay, so that will be easier to handle. Got it? Now, if the number of terms are even, suppose if the number of terms are even, n is equal to some even number. N is some even number. So I have suppose say 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if n is an even, you can see there is nothing which is coming in the middle. There are two terms which are in the middle. So what we'll do, the middle two terms, the left one I will write as a minus d and the right one I will write as a plus d. The left one I will write as a minus d, the right one I will write as a plus d. And you can see now the common difference. Earlier the common difference was d. So my first term, suppose if n is equal to 3, so my first term is a minus d and my common difference is d only, because every time it is increasing by d. Common difference is equal to d. But yaha pe common difference will no longer be d, because if you will see the difference between a plus d and a minus d, so a plus d subtracted from a minus d, you will get a plus d minus a minus into minus is plus d. So common difference is 2d now. So remember, when the number of terms are even, when you are taking this as your AP, your common difference will be 2d. This part many students will forget that the common difference is 2d in this kind of an AP. Got it? So a minus d, a plus d, so keep increase by 2d. So a plus 3d and here a minus 3d. Got it? If one more term you want, a plus 5d and here a minus 5d. So if n is equal to 4, this is the form. If n is equal to 6, this is the form. Got it? So this is how the AP will work. So just remember, for the value of n, if n is odd, the first form. If n is even, the second form. So this is how the terms we will be substituting in that AP. गॉट इट. चलो तो लेट्स लुक एट द क्वेश्चन. अच्छा अर्थमेटिक मीन क्या होता है बेटा? अर्थमेटिक मीन होता है दैट सपोज इफ थ्री नंबर्स आर इन एन एपी. सो ए लेट्स से ए बी एंड सी दे आर इन एपी. तो आई नो इफ दे आर इन एपी आई कैन से द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू एंड डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू विल बी कॉन्स्टेंट. सो बी माइनस ए इज इक्वल टू सी माइनस बी. राइट शिफ्ट माइनस ए ओवर माइनस ए ओवर हियर माइनस बी ओवर देयर. तो बी प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस सी. सो 2b इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस सी. सो b इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस सी बाय 2. b इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस सी बाय 2. सो सेम थिंग इफ a इज द मिडल टर्म. सो द मिडल टर्म इज कॉल्ड द अर्थमेटिक मीन ऑफ द अदर टू टर्म्स. गॉट इट. सो दिस b इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस सी बाय 2 विल बी योर अर्थमेटिक मीन. देखा यहां से नॉर्मली फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन यू आर गेटिंग इट. ओके नथिंग हाई फाई. गॉट इट. चलो लेट्स लुक एट सम क्वेश्चंस. तो बेटा देखो क्वेश्चंस क्या बोल रहे हैं. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सेज फाइंड द सम ऑफ फर्स्ट 22 टर्म्स ऑफ एन एपी. अब देखो हियर यू नो द फर्स्ट टर्म ए इज इक्वल टू 8. योर कॉमन डिफरेंस डी इज 3 माइनस 8 इज 3 माइनस 8 विच इज माइनस 5. रिमेंबर ए 2 माइनस ए 1 एनी टर्म माइनस द प्रीवियस टर्म एंड द नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स इज गिवन एज 22. सो बेटर टू यूज द फॉर्मूला सम ऑफ 22 टर्म्स विल बी एन बाय 2. सो just first writing the formula sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So sum of 22 terms will be 22 by 2 into 2 into 8 plus 22 minus 1 into d is minus 5. Correct. So sum of 22 terms will be 22 by 2 is 11 into 8 to the 16 and 22 minus 1 is 21. 21 into minus 5 is minus 105. Correct. So you will be getting sum of 22 terms as 11 into 16 minus 105. So if it was 15, so 900 and 90, so into minus 89. So multiply those. So 979 minus of 979 is your correct answer. Okay, minus of 979 is your correct answer. Simple direct formula question, right? Next question dekho. How many terms of the AP 24, 21, 18 and so on must be taken so that their sum is 78? So here they have given me the AP. When A and D is given, now the question is very easy. Okay, so here I can clearly say, sir, my first term is 24. My common difference is 21 minus 24, which is equal to minus 3. Okay, and number of terms I need to find out, where I have told you that sum of n terms should be 78. What is n? I need to find out. So obviously, I will use the formula for Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So Sn sum is given as 78. N by 2 into 2 into 24 is 48 plus n minus 1 into d is what? Minus 3. So 78, this by 2 if I shift it over there, this upon 2 if I shift it over there, so it will become 78 into 2. So 78 into 2 will be equal to what? 156 is equal to n into, this will be 48, minus 3 into n is minus 3n, minus 3 into minus 1 is plus 3. Okay, so you are getting 156 is equal to 48 plus 3 is 51, 51 into n is 51n, and n into minus 3n is minus 3n square. So we are getting shift minus 3n square over there, so 3n square minus 51n plus 156 is equal to 0. So you are getting a quadratic equation. I can take 3 common, right? So if I take 3 common, so it will be n square minus 17n plus 52 is equal to 0. So we want two numbers such that their addition is minus 17 and their multiplication is 52. So 52 we know 13 fours are. So minus 13 minus 4, because we want the sum to be minus 17. So n square minus 13n minus 4n plus 52 equal to 0. So if you factorize this, take n common, n minus 13. Take minus 4 common, n minus 13 equal to 0. So you'll be getting n minus 13 into n minus 4 equal to 0. So from here, we will get that either n is equal to 13 or n is equal to 4. That means ki beta either add the 13 terms or add the first 4 terms. Ab you must be thinking ki sir, how is it possible? Whether we add the 4 terms or we add the 13 terms, the sum is same, right? This question must be coming to your mind. Bhai, if the calculation is telling me, it must be true. So how it is true that the sum of 13 terms and the sum of 4 terms both are equal to each other? So beta, what happens here is, if you will see this question carefully, this is a decreasing AP. This is one decreasing AP. So it will be 24, 21, 18. Okay, so let me write this AP up to 13 terms so that you will get the idea, hai na? So 18, 15, okay, 24. Dekho, n is equal to 4 bol raha hai. That means if I add all these 4, my sum will be 78. You can check this part also. Okay, then it will be 12, 9, okay, 6, 3, 0, minus 3, minus 6, minus 9, and minus 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Ab dekho beta, after if I take the sum of 13 terms, so from here to here, since this was a decreasing AP, array, what happened? Since it was a decreasing AP, the sum is 0 from S5 to S, if from A5 to A13, the sum is becoming 0. Right, so when the decreasing AP is there, dekho, pehle sum increase, after 0, the sum again started decreasing. Got it? So this is how this AP, there are two values, sum of 4 terms and the sum of 13 terms is also 78. Got it? So calculations are never wrong if you are doing it correctly. Okay, so n is equal to 4 or n is equal to 13 will be your correct answer. Let's go for the next question. The next question is this. Find the sum of first 51 terms of an AP whose second and third terms are 14 and 18 respectively. So they are saying find out the sum of first 51 terms whose second and third term are 14 and 18. So ek baat batao beta, if A2 is 14 and if A3 is 18, so I can say common difference is equal to A3 minus A2, that is 18 minus 14, which is equal to 4. And I can say, sir, A2 is equal to A plus B, A plus N minus 1 into D. So 14 is equal to A plus 4. So from here, we have got A is equal to 10. So the AP is this, 10, 14, 18, and so on. So we have to find out the sum up to the 51st term. So now it is directly solving question N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. We know N is equal to 51, A is equal to 10, and D is equal to 4. Bas put the values, get the answer. Right? Just put the values and get the answer. So when you'll put the values over here, you will be getting the answer as 5610. Okay, so the sum of 51 terms of this AP will be 5610. Now, before I move ahead, I would like to tell all of you that whatever problems you were facing till now, wherever you were studying, those problems you will not face now at Vedantu, because for each and every class, we have a dedicated teacher to take care of your doubts. Notes and assignments are provided after every class. Tests are taken in a regular interval of time, that too on the pattern of your examinations. Competitive examinations like NTSC, KVPY, Olympiad, no need to go anywhere else. Everything will be done at Vedantu. Schedule, that is, ki suppose if you miss your class because of some reason, you can always watch the recording of that class wherever you want, whenever you want, and the choice of language, that is Hindi or English. Other than that, unlimited live classes, all micro and crash courses are free of cost. Crash courses are revision course and micro courses are the chapter specific course. So you can revise a chapter as many times as you want. You can study the chapter, whatever chapter you want to study first, you can study that chapter first. Performance reports and personalized attention to each and every kid. Okay, So the link is vdnt.in/ytpro, and the coupon code for you is GPEPRO. This coupon code will give you 15% off it will get you. Okay, so whatever is the price, flat 15% discount on that price, GPEPRO. I will tell you the fee details also at the end of the class. ठीक है, तो अभी आगे बढ़ते हैं, let's focus on this class. So, we have find three numbers in an AP whose sum is 24 and whose product is 440. Now, here you see, they have given the sum of the terms, product of the terms, and they have not given what is the first term and what is the common difference. Right, so here, I will use that part. वही जो I have taught you कि भाई if n is equal to odd, this is how you will assume your AP. If n is equal to even, this is how you will assume your AP. तो n is what? n is equal to 3. That means n is odd. So what I have told कि बेटा middle term take it as a. Previous to that a minus d and after that a plus d. Got it? These are my three terms. Now they are told that their sum is 24. So I can say sir a minus d plus a plus d is given as 24. So minus d and plus d will get cancelled. 3a is equal to 24. So a is equal to 8. That means this middle term is equal to 8. This middle term is equal to 8. So I can say sir now my AP is something like this. Kaisa hai? Is tarike se 1, 2, 3. So 8 minus d, 8 and 8 plus d. Now only thing left is to find out d. How do you get it? Simple. Whose product is 440. So product means 8 minus d into 8 plus d is equal to 440. Shift 8 in division. We are left here with 8 minus d into 8 plus d is equal to 8 fives are 40, 55. So it will be 8 minus d into 8 plus d is 64 minus d square is equal to 55. D square over there, 55 over here. So d square is 64 minus 55. That is d square is equal to 9. So d is equal to plus minus 3. ठीक है? D is equal to plus minus 3. तो देखो, I have got two cases. I have got two cases. When my AP is 8 minus d, 8 and 8 plus d. So first case, if I take d equal to 3, so in that case 8 minus 3, 8 and 8 plus 3, so that will be 5, 8 and 11. That is first AP. Okay, and if I take my common difference as minus 3, 8 minus d, 8 and 8 plus d, if I take d is equal to minus 3, so it will be 8 minus d is again minus 3, comma 8 and 8 plus d is minus 3. So it will become 8 minus into minus is plus 3, 8 and plus into minus is minus. So 11, 8 and 5. So in case of d is positive or negative, just the AP reverses. So when the common difference is changed from positive to negative, the AP is reversed. The answer remains same. Okay, so the three numbers are 5, 8 and 11. No matter in which order you write. 11, 8, 5 or 5, 8, 11. As simple as that. Got it? So this is how this question will be solved. Next question, dekho. Divide 96 into 4 parts which are in AP and the ratio between product of their means to the product of their extremes is 57. So they are saying ki beta 96 is a number, divide it into 4 parts in such a way that they will be in an AP. So 4 parts, the question is telling me to divide 96 in 4 parts. So n is equal to 4. That means n is an even number. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. What I have told? The middle two ones, a minus d, a plus d. And here, since the common difference has become 2d, so a plus 3d, and here a minus 3d. Right? Remember, here the common difference is 2d. Got it? ठीक है? अब देखो बेटा, since all these 4, 96 I have divided into these 4 numbers, obviously I can say that sir the sum of these 4 numbers will be 96. So I can say sir a minus 3d plus a minus d plus a plus 3d is equal to 96. And the benefit is, देखो, minus d plus d, minus 3d got cancelled. So 4a is equal to 96. So a is equal to 4 2's are 8, 4 4's are 16. So a is equal to 24. Right? A is equal to 24. So my now my numbers are 24 minus 3d. Okay. Then 24 minus d, 24 plus d, and 24 plus 3d. Then they are saying the product of their means, that means the middle one, if you multiply to the product of their extreme, the ratio is 15 is to 7. So the ratio between product of their means, that is 24 minus d into 24 plus d divided by extremes 24 minus 3d into 24 plus 3d. This product is in the ratio 15 is to 7. Multiply them. So it will be 24 square minus d square. 24 square is 576 minus d square is equal to here 576 minus 9d square is equal to 15 is to 7. Is equal to what? 15 is to 7. So let's solve this part. So 576 minus d square. Okay. 576 minus d square into 7 is equal to 576 minus 9d square into 15. ठीक है, तो it is 576 into 7 रखते हैं, minus 7d square is equal to 576 into 15, minus 69 जा 135d square. Shift minus 135 over here, this 576 over here. So minus 135 d square will become plus 135 d square minus 7 d square is equal to 576 into 15 minus 576 into 7. ठीक है, तो it will be equal to 128 d square. And if I take 576 common, I am left with 15 minus 7. Okay, so d square will be equal to 576 into 15 minus 7 is 8 divided by 128, right? And I can say ki sir, this will be divisible by 8. 8 ones are, yes, 8 ones are, and remainder 4, 8 6 are 48, and 16 ones are, 16 3 are 48, 16 6 are 96. So d square is equal to 36. That means d is equal to plus minus 6. I have told you both the values you need to check, but the AP will just be reversed. Okay. So my numbers were 24 minus 3d, 24 minus d, 24 plus d, and 24 plus 3d. So if I put d equal to 6, so 24 minus 3 into 18, 24 minus 3, sorry, 24 minus 3 into 6, that is 18. 24 minus 18 is equal to 6. Okay, 24 minus 6 is equal to 18. 24 plus 6 is equal to 30. And 24 plus 18 will be equal to, kya hai yahan pe? 42. Got it? So this is your AP. 6, 18, 30, 42. 6, 18, 30, 42. And if you take D as minus 6, so it will be 42, 30, 18 and 6. Got it? So either increasing or decreasing, the four parts will be 6, 18, 30 and 42. Got it? Chalo, let's go for the next question. Next question, dekho, find 5 numbers in an AP whose sum is 12 and a half and the ratio of the first to the last term is 2 is to 3. And a ratio of the first to the last term is 2 is to 3. So what they are saying, ki beta 5 numbers are there and a 5 numbers are. So they are in AP, the sum is 12 and a half and the ratio of the first to the last term is 2 is to 3. This question ko I would like you to solve. Isko solve karna. Sum diya hua hai, 5 numbers is given. Try to solve this part. Theek hai? Try to solve this question. Okay? Chalo. So this is your homework question. Try to attempt this question. Let me see how will you solve this question. As I was saying at you in the middle of the session that this link here, if you'll go to this link vdnt.in/ytpro, and if you apply the coupon code GPEPRO, then you will get 15% off. So let's see, if you'll go to this link, you will see this page, select your grade 10th, ICSE 2021. Okay, and click here on get subscription. After that, here in the coupon code, you have to write GPE Pro to get 15% discount. You have an option to choose for 1 month, 3 months, or 6 months. Everywhere the coupon code will be applicable. Everywhere you will be getting the price, you will be getting the 15% discount everywhere by using the coupon code GPE Pro. But you will see the more benefit you will get if you take more number of months, because first thing, when you are with us for a longer period of time, your study will be in more detail, in more depth, and you will feel more confident. The second thing is your price per month will also reduce. For example, the price for 1 month after discount is 2294, that is around 2300. But the price for 6 months is 9774. So if you will divide it by 6, it will be around 1600 and something. So you can see the clear difference in the price per month. Got it? So all of you are more than welcome to join Vedantu subscription part. This is the link and this is the coupon code. Got it? So this is all from my side, beta. Thank you so much for attending the session. I hope all of you enjoyed the session. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and share the video with your friends. Please don't forget to like the video. I'll see you soon. Till then, bye bye, sayonara, khuda hafiz to all of you. Bye bye.